pray for me tomorrow. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, pray for the pastor.
Neighbor, pray for the pastor.
Always, always.
I'll tell you why you gotta pray for me. Because I'm different. And I have a big problem right now. And the problem is that when we come to church just to show our face, come to church just to because it's Easter Sunday. We do stuff. We do stuff that we're supposed to do, but not what we really want to do. I wonder if there's still some people that really want to praise God, really want to glorify God. Are there any people that's just not doing it because you were told to, but you was pushed to? But is it a part of your life schedule? Oh, thank you, Jesus. I wonder if praise is like eating to you. Because sometimes we treat praise like brushing our teeth. Sometimes you don't brush your teeth. I'm being real. And today, I don't want to do the shenanigans, so I don't want to do the he got up preaching. Because it's more than this, he got up. It's so much bigger than that. And it's so much more than that, that if we really get the importance of the reason of Easter, we'll realize that Easter must be every Sunday.
That's right.
Hallelujah. We shouldn't just remember that he got up on Easter Sunday. We should remember that God got up every Sunday, every day. Because without him getting up, there will be no remission of sin. Without him getting up, there will be no evidence that there's a kingdom. But because he got up, it lets us know that we got a place. And we got a place in that Lamb's Book of Life. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So I am going to read the scripture. We're going to give 3 points. I got 3 points for you. 3 points for you. And then we're going to get on out your way and we're going to handle the other things that we need to do. Amen.
Amen.
But if y'all don't mind, I just want to read the scripture for you, the 24th chapter of Luke. Am I missing anything? 24th chapter of Luke. On the first day of the week, very early in the morning. This is not the right Bible. This is not the right one. This is the New Living. This is the Amplified Living Bible. Yeah, I need King. You know me. I love KJV. Yeah. Now, upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came to the sepulchre bringing spices, which they had prepared. Certain others with them, they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. They entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And they were afraid, bowed down their faces to the earth. They said unto them, why seek ye the living amongst the dead? Let me tell y'all something. If I was really, really ready to preach, I would preach, why do you seek me amongst the dead? Yes. You touch your neighbor and say, nigga, why ye seek thee?
Why seek me?
The living.
The living.
Among the dead.
Among the dead.
Hallelujah. Then it says in verse 6, he is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, the Son of Man must be delivered in the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day rise again. And they remembered his words. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we glorify you and we honor you for your word on today. Father, I pray now that you would touch your manservant as we begin, oh God, to explore your word. I pray now, oh God, that you would touch these believers, that they would learn this text and help them in their life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hey, Elder Samuel, let me see my phone because I don't think this clock is right. So I want to make sure. Stay on top of this. Amen. Amen. Listen. The first thing that I want to is 3 points that I want to deal with, and I don't want to be here long. The first point that I would like to bring to your bring to the table is that Jesus' burial was only preparation for his resurrection.
Okay.
First thing I want you to understand is that when we look at Easter Sunday, we cannot look at the resurrection without looking at the burial.
Yeah.
Cannot look at having all power with being stripped. Amen.
Amen.
He had all power, but they stripped Jesus. They stripped him of fame.
Mm-hmm.
They beat him. And to make a long story short, he endured hardship.
Yeah.
And what we have to realize is that hardship is only a part of your healing process.
Okay.
Hardship is only a part of your blessings.
Yeah.
Understand right now, believer, that you cannot have blessings without hardship.
Come on.
You don't even to know miracles without hardship. Because if there's no hardship, there is no need for miracles.
Yeah.
Understand that the things that you are going through and the things that seems to be rough is only there to prepare you for a more excellent end. That's why the Bible said, be not weary in your well-doing. Because that same scripture promises a due season.
Yeah.
Am I getting everybody? Understand that Job had to go through so he can win at the end.
Yeah.
You push your neighbor and say, neighbor, we're going to win at the end.
We're going to win at the end.
Well, yeah, I can talk under the Holy Ghost. The burial was only preparation for the resurrection. But see, people understood and thought that they were killing Jesus. Lord, have mercy. I'm going to say this to Nikki's side because they didn't catch it over here. People thought that they were killing Jesus.
Uh-huh.
I had you, but I'm gonna try this middle one now. People thought that they were killing Jesus, but did not know that they were really setting him up.
Yeah.
So what I gotta realize, I gotta make you understand that when people think that they're getting over on you, they think that they are winning against you.
Come on.
And they think that they are running you down or trying to kill you, trying to hurt you, trying to break you, trying to make you busted, confused, and disappointed. But what they don't know, they're setting you up for success and they're setting themselves up for failure.
Wow.
They literally was laughing at him.
Yes.
They laughed at him while they beat him. Talked about him, mistreated him, and we cannot deal with the resurrection without dealing with the way to the cross.
That's right.
Understand, you have a journey to the cross.
Yeah.
And your journey to Christ is not going to be an easy journey. No believers has an easy life. Let me say that to the camera. No believer has an easy life.
Yeah.
And the reason that you don't have an easy life is because you're being prepared for perfection.
Right. Mm. Say it again.
The reason that you do not have an easy life is because God is preparing you for perfection.
Yeah.
You got to make all your mistakes right here.
That's right.
You got to make all your mess ups right here.
That's right.
Because when it's time to go to glory, ain't no time for mess ups.
That's right. No mess
up. So understand that when you see those things that come to knock you down, or when you see those things that come trying to break you and discourage you, you have to realize that you're on the divine test.
Right. Yeah.
You're on the divine test. Did you look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you're under the divine test.
Under the divine test.
You got to realize that every step you make and every decision you make is being watched by the Master. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, I love God. Every time you make a decision, God is looking at you. That's why when you make the wrong decision, you know what you got to do right then? You got to apologize. Say, Lord, forgive me for I've made a mistake. Because this journey to the cross is not what?
Easy.